Shout out to Elon Musk. Call me sometime.
What's up, guys? I'm back. It's been a while. It's been quite some time, but you know, like I said, I'm back. And first, I want to say I'll be in El Paso this weekend, so I kind of wanted to vlog and kind of show you guys, you know, my day-to-day and, you know, things I do out there, whatever. But I guess I wanted to talk to you guys about something that's kind of been on my mind for a little bit, and just reflection, right? So I moved to Texas last year, and ever since I've been here, I notice whether I go to grocery stores or it's like barbershop or even like movie theaters or clubs, bars, whatever, which is kind of rare, but I notice that people look at me in like a weird way. And I've always, like, I'd say ever since like middle school, I've been kind of labeled as like the alternative weird kid, whatever that means to you, but just somebody who was different, you know what I mean? Somebody who just didn't fit that mold. And I remember, like, even back at college, you know, I mean, I was kind of a loner, I'm just gonna be honest, just because the things that I wanted to do, or a lot of people were not into, or just found it just weird, man. And, you know, honestly, I started to become more introverted, you know, because when you have people who are not validating your feelings, and you have people who, you know, just kind of like pushing you off to the side, like, okay, whatever, like, let's just leave him over here. Like, man, that's, I can take a toll on you. So, you know, nowadays, like, I embrace that. I guess that's my message, like, to you guys right now, is to embrace that. You know, I look at people I look up to as far as, like, the Tyler creators of the world. He's a huge influence on my life right now. Or you can even look at Childish Gambino's, Issa Rae, Solange. She's another one. Or even like Jaden Smith. Just like those kids, or those people who don't fit the mold of like what Black society views us to be. We're kind of outside of that. And it's not like we're better or worse than anybody. It's just, we just do our own thing, you know. And I'm just encouraging you guys to embrace that. Like, as cliche as it sounds, like, you have to be yourself. Like, I know that might sound like, oh, everybody says that. But no, seriously, like, you have to be yourself, because I don't know. I mean, people can tell when you're faking it. Like, when you're trying to do something, like, versus that's just being you. You know, you can see through it. But I just want to encourage you guys to, you know, just embrace who you are. People are going to have an opinion regardless. You know, whether it's good or bad, just take it with a grain of salt and just keep it moving. Seriously, I mean, they're going to have their opinions, and you can't change their mind, nor should you try to. You know, it's all about perception. You know, their perception of you is this, you know. And it's easy sometimes to get caught up in trying to fit in. You know, we have a lot of faces. I was talking to one of my friends about this. We have a lot of faces that we put on for different people. Like, we have a face for our friends, we have a face for our parents, our coworkers. If we're in school, our principal, whatever, you know, even if we're in a relationship, you know, we have a face for them. And so, like, the energy that I'm on right now is just having one face. So whoever I'm talking to, like, okay, that's Mac, like that's him, you know what I mean? And not try to fake it or act a certain way about certain guys or act a way around certain women. Just no, like this is who I am, and either you're with me, you're on board, or you're not. It's just as simple as that. So I want to encourage you guys to embrace that awkwardness. You know, whether you're the only person doing it, whether you stand out from a crowd, you know, whether people don't like the way that you eat, the music you listen to, your style, you know, just do it, man. Like, I'm not saying like F other people, but I'm just saying like, you have to focus on yourself and you have to be genuine about it and just say, you know what? I'm just going to do the things that I want to do. And I've been doing that. And it feels so great when you don't have that fear of being rejected. You don't have that fear of trying to fit in. Man, you really can just start living life because you're not concerned about that validation. That's what it is. It's the validation that we get from others. And like not feeding off of that and not needing that, man. Not needing that acceptance. Man, it's a good thing. I'm not going to lie. So, I just wanted to encourage you guys about that. And I know, you know, some people who watch me who are also, you know, kind of, I guess other would say quirky or whatever. But, like, no, man, just do you. And, again, nobody can be you but you. Just it's as simple as it is. So, like I said, I'll be in El Paso this weekend. And I just wanted to share that message with you guys before I take you along the journey. But, again, I'm back. It's good to see you guys. I'll see you guys on the road. Peace.
Loved, then lost, then loved again, unconditionally. Happy. You joke that I'm rich, and I am, but not how you think. I live in a Tudor house under the freeway, off of Rose Avenue, 12 blocks from the beach. And when you call, I put your sweater on, put you on speaker, and chat for hours underneath the trees. Think about the last time you were here, lying next to me. How the noise from the cars got louder and louder during rush hour, until it sounded like a river or a stream. And it felt like we were swimming, but it wasn't just a dream. We were just happy.
I mean, it's about 600 or 700 feet of elevation, so not too bad. It's just I didn't bring the right shoes, and so I'm trying to navigate out here. Oh, I'll be fine now. Hey guys, my battery died. Yeah, that was cool. High as shit, not gonna lie. But it was cool just being up there and seeing all of El Paso, and it's so peaceful too. It's only like five to six people on the trail, so not too many. And plus, again, it was windy, so that probably deterred a lot of people. But just made it to this coffee shop. What is it called? 210 coffee. Probably gonna get some, I don't know, maybe an omelet or something. Just get some coffee, wake up, kind of relax for the day. But I don't know what I'm getting into later, but we'll see. I'll see you inside. So I got a iced chai latte with oat milk. That's what I usually get. other side looks even better as far as.
I always get the same thing. Which high? Can't get which high. Pretty cool place. It's called the coffee box just because it's like, you know, shipment container. Yeah. Pretty cool idea. So that's the end of the video. I appreciate you guys. If you enjoyed the video, give it a big thumbs up, follow down below, maybe share it, whatever you want to do. But I'll see you guys soon. And remember, only you can be you. So whatever you want in life, do that shit. I love you guys. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.